Folks, Luca, Sharper Trades, a positive day in Wall Street. It was a bit weird. First of all, it was a fantastic day. Many of our swings reached second targets. I took some profit myself, OPD2 at least part. They continue to move our swings, so very, very bullish, except for a couple GM broker support. It's holding the secondary support. We'll cover that in a moment. So the S&P 500 gave us a little bit of a shake right an hour after the opening. And this rollover was very steep. It started to form a bear flag, or a V-bottom. Did a V-bottom here, pullback retest, held the 381 support, that was the area we were looking at, and nicely came back above the VWAP, and then it went higher into the close. So a bullish move. And if anything, is a hammer with the longer lower shadow, that's bullish. Volume is bullish, so we'll go higher, right? Or at least that's the idea. 393 and 401 support today low, and then this low Friday 373. Take a look at the individual stocks. Communication sector. Communication equipment, they're all through the roof. AKTS, swing idea, reached the target at 17.48, came as high as 18. Pullback volume is good. It's a channel top, so you might have to consolidate a little bit. Next target, 19 and 21.50. The support is today low and 14. AMC, swing idea. Breakout reached the target today for 81. A pullback consolidation, good volume. For me, the support is 385. Secondary support is the 18. Next target 6760 and 964. AMTX, a fantastic day trade. Consolidated for part of the day. Popped here, pullback retest base. Here broke the support and then recovered. One higher, pullback retest again, and then exploded during the lunch hour at 11. And then a pullback broke the channel bottom. So this was done at this level. From the daily chart, it's a channel top. So this one might have to pull back. It was stopped last week, I think it was Andre. Congratulations if you held on to this position. A big move today from four when it was discussed last week to today, the high was 11. It's a channel top, so I will expect some pullback or at least consolidation. If you're swinging it today, low is your stop. Any move below that, there is a big gap, we will try to fill it. With the support, the secondary support will be here at the HMA. If it continues to move or tries to go higher, our next targets 13, 15. Let's see, is that the all-time high? No way. So this has a lot of room for expansion if it continues higher. 1785, 2050, and 24. Again, this was just a day trade for us. Done. AQMS, I continue following this. Is in no list, but in case you're trading, this is very bullish. This is related to the electric revolution. So as long as that stuff goes on, this will continue to move higher. There's a stops, obviously. Today popped, it's a breakout of this trend line. I came near the target at 6.10. My target was 6.30. Above that, looking for 8 and then 10.57, eventually channel top mid-February, 13.47. It's a short, right? The support today low and then Thursday low F4. BABA, it's off the list for me, but maintains a bullish look. The reason I'm covering this is because if you continue to trade it, it's still bullish as long as it remains above the 50. Targets 283 and 300. BD, incredible. This was a swing here, reached several targets, took it off the list, and then on Friday, I sent a message again that was breaking and was a re-entry opportunity. And today open, it was at 21. 21, that was it was a big resistance right there. Let's see. Right, those lows right there. So this was a good place to take profit. Still very bullish. This is the monthly chart, back to the daily chart. But this is the resistance. So I will expect some consolidation. In the after-hour market is up a little bit, 1950. If he's able to break and hold that 20-30 area, next targets 21-41, 24-27, and 30. This is also again off the list. We did the two waves up, one, two, three, and three wave up. And if you continue to hold this position, your stop is today low at 15-70. BBY, this was mentioned on Friday. And then today was a day trade that worked really well, explosive right at the open. It pulled back the test nicely, then ran to the target at 45, 43.80, and then to my next target is 48. And then came down heavy, a big move on the number volume increase. This after reaching two targets. And he was up, I think, 30%. From, let's see, from 31. Yeah, it was almost 50%. So you gotta take your profit at some point, right? Anyway, this is ready for a pullback, massive volume. Many buyers were caught in this reversal. And but keep an eye on it because any pullback at the mid channel could be a good reentry near 28, the ATMA, we'll see. Now this is a steep reversal. This is a shooting star, so careful. Bingo. Oh, Binamo continues to move, breakout of the all-time high, which was 10.03 actually, for the number properly, if we can do that. There you go, 10.03. And so this is a breakout, that, bullish. And I took some profit today. It was entered on Friday as it was closing and spiking. And some of you I know did as well. Amen, and some of the others. So today it's a breakout, good volume. I'm looking for 14, 17, and 20. Those are the next targets. The support today low, 10.40. Let's call it 10 for simplicity, and then 80. BWEN, another day trade that worked well. Open, nicely consolidated about 1080. I love when they do this. This sinus consolidation with a very low risk, 1080 was the stop, and then exploded, pulled back the test and rallied to the target, 1220. That was a $1.50 run almost to 1287, 1289, and that was $2 run. A pullback retest and then broke the support for me. This point was down and it breaks. Makes this consolidation and then breaks, number volume, done. The VAX breakout, the vaccine stocks are back in people's mind. Several of them made a move today. The VAX was initiated phase two trial. Breakout with volume, this it's an important move. It's a technical breakout of the trend line. It's volatile, so cautious, but looks wants to go some more. 7, 8.20, 9.45, 10.70, and 12.40. Support half of today candle, 5.70, and today low, 5.20. GM has swing worked really well. Broke out here, we enter a position, rally to multiple targets, reached 1, 2, 3, 4 target, came as high as 56.97. And then a pullback, a channel top. This most likely it needs to at least consolidation and most likely a pullback. This took profit a few days ago, I think Thursday. I will look for a re-entry, but I'm going to look for a pullback down near the 47 level. Now, today, the Biden administration spoke about having a replacement of all their fleet with electric vehicles made in America. Now that's a big undertake because as Steve pointed out, some of the companies we're following, they don't have, either Chinese or Canadian, or they don't have the capability of massive production. GM and Ford are the one that are actually the one that can do it, but they're a little bit behind. The GM is catching up, Ford is behind, in my opinion. Anyway, and Tesla, obviously, but they're not going to have Teslas for government employees and people, maybe the president, the vice president, and who knows that was. I don't think so. Anyway, look for a pullback, or at least if you continue to trade this position, your stop is below today low 51. We had two stops, 54 and 52. Eventually, 59 and 63 are the next targets. And then, go, a little bit of grief is very bullish. This one exploded, it was a day trade and also a swing idea. Popped and then drop on massive volume. When you see this kind of volume, it's a, you know, 1 million single order. That's a catalyst for the next move. And it came, it broke out, rallied. I day traded this one. I almost exited this position. Then I was doing something else and I lost this pullback. And then I exit with a little bit of a gain, but you know, I didn't get this drop because that would be upsetting. And nevertheless, I broke primary and secondary support, but then it reversed, as I mentioned in the room. This maintained a bullish look. This was when the market was pulling back. This also pulled back. Stabilized above 1260, 1250. And then when I, now this on the daily chart is a big volume breakout of this trend line and 1340. Targets are 16, 61, 18 and 20. This is a telecom service communication. So with this 5G taking place, it's a key player, I think. But also very volatile. So if you trade those kind of companies, just be aware of that. The support is 1340 and then the ATMA. HIMX continues this consolidation. Today picked up some volume. I like the look of it. My second target, 960. This moves slowly enough. Easier to manage, except sometimes that's those bit of a reversal. But anyway, easier to manage compared to some of the others. Second target is 960, third target 11. Support ATMA and 770. INSG, I took a good profit with this on broke out. I had a position through here, broke out on Tuesday. That's when we initiated the swing. This is the first target, pullback. I enter more position, and then today I exploded to the second target. I took profit at 2140. And channel top, big volume. This looks like wants some more, but again, because it's the channel top, we might have to consolidate a little bit. My fourth target, third target is 27, 24. 27 is the fourth target, which is also the all-time high. Is it? No. The all-time high precisely. It's 29, okay, 29.10. 29.10 is the ultimate, remember that? So there is room for expansion. The support, 20, and the ATMA, so 18. Jeremiah was a day trade on Friday, and today a continuation pattern with a long legged doji and lower shadow, and closing above Friday high. So this is a dragonfly doji, wants to fly, good volume. Next target, 63, 71, and 78. Support, if you are swinging it, this is was a swing for us for here. There, steep pullback, and now it's going high. It's a breakout all time high, bullish. So the support, if you're swinging it, 53, and then yesterday or Friday low at 45. JMPR, also in the communication equipment, a breakout of the 25.30. They came as high as 25.60, 25.70, and then a pullback. Volume is good, bullish. Third target is 26.57. Fourth target, 27.60. The support, we're tightening, 24.50, 23.50. Moderna breakout with volume. Positive news today that their vaccine seems to be effective also with the new mutations, the new variations of COVID, dot, dot, dot. Not to say anything. Big volume and again, vaccine are back in the spotlight, 178, next target, 210. 210 is the ultimate, no? 178 is the ultimate. So there will be a big resistance. If he's able to push through that, 210, 251, and 295 channel top. Support 80MA and this low at 120. NNDM keeps on giving big volume, volume increase, bullish. There is the target, 1775. A longer lower shadow, and then right back where it started with, again, another Dragonfly Doji with the lower shadow longer, so that's bullish. If it extends and is able to break it in and hold, next target 20, 22, 24. Support, 15 and the ATMA. Knock. Knock keeps on giving big volume. This was mentioned a few days ago here. Andrei, or I can't remember, one of you guys, and I don't trade this company because it's an international, gaps up, gaps down. I never like this motion, but again, it's in the communication equipment, big volume. It keeps in massive dark pool. And now this is breaking out in the after hour market. This five looks like wants to go higher. 540 next targets above the 8, 6 and 665. Big dark pool near 550, 570 and 580. So room for expansion. The support is today low, 450. I mean 450, not 550. OPTT reached the target 633 and came near the next target, the 740. The high was 730. Pullback, an indecision, a channel top. So sideways consolidation, it's okay. If it breaks below the low, which is your primary support, it will come down here and test the ATMA, secondary support. Next target, if it goes higher, 850, 10 and 12. PLTR. This is an incredible trade. I took profit today when it broke out, reached 38. I exited 37, 36.50, somewhere in the level, and then gradually re-entered the position as it was pulling back. And it's working again, a big volume. I think this we're gonna see at some point, maybe in a month, or hopefully sooner, 50. And then channel top here at 47, 57. It's a breakout and it's confirming. Very bullish with the volume increase. The support 33 and today low 30, 29.50. Pola, the trade component, reached the target at 27 and the channel top today came as high as 31. My next target was 32.20. Didn't quite make to that level, but a few pennies shy of it. Next target, if he continues this bullish run, which is in the momentum, 37, 44, 51, one more, 60. Right now it's 27, that could be twice as much, but it's also very volatile, so the risk is just as great. So don't do that, don't risk just as much, okay, smaller risk. Support is today low and the ATMA. Okay, RT, this was a swing that we kept seeing some dark pool activity, but it wasn't working at that point. Stopped falling. Then Marwan pointed out tonight, it was breaking out, took out the resistance trend line. On the pullback, I gave you the entry opportunity near 22, 40, whatever that was, somewhere in this level. Yeah, right, let's consider the 1 minute chart. Right around this level, 22, 22.40. In the after hour market is up a little bit, 23. It's a breakout. Yeah. It's a breakout with big volume, and it's a breakout of this triangle that has been waiting since, it's been forming since, let's call it October. So that's a 4 month breakout. So that's a lot of pressure has been built in and now it's popping, big volcano, explosive. Looking for 24, first target, 26, 28, and then fourth target, 31. Support, we'll keep it loose, 21 and 20. SDC, I don't like this company. This is a bullish breakout in volume. And we've seen this bullish breakout with volume way too many times. It worked for 3 days and then it broke. Worked for a day and then it broke. So I'm staying away from this one. But it's bullish. And some of you were up, pointed out, and There's a lot of energy behind it with the today 24 million traded shares. Let's see if he's able to break this high, 14.14. Next targets, 14.40, 15.40, 16.50, and 17.80. The support is up for this big candle for 12.40, 12.50, and then the 50 SMA, simple moving average. Solo, they break out, and then got screwed up when market pulled back, and it didn't recover. I mean, it did a little bit, but not significant. It needed to come back above the VWP. It didn't do that. It rolled over, got a bounce, flat. Yeah, I don't like that. What I want to see is back above the 9. This is an important resistance. It wasn't able to break an old. It popped above and then pulled back right below it. So let's see if it breaks an old at 9. Next target's 10, 12, 14, 16, 30. Very volatile. Support is the 80 MA and the 50 simple the moving average. Space also took profit today, right at the target at 38.18. That's when I sold it. Remains bullish, big volume. Technicals intraday also bullish with a support above 35. Also tighten the stops. This has reached the second target and is breaking out of this recent high. Let's see, 35.80 close at 36. So that's a breakout. The support, let's see, 35. And let's see if I modify it. Whatever message I sent you, I can't remember. I don't have the value in front of me. But whatever message I sent you in remind, that those are the value. For the sake of this video, let's say 35 and today low 32. Teladoc, it's extending breakout swing idea 253. Today is the first target and the second target nearby, almost 300. The high was 294.74. Channel top, we might see that tomorrow, a test at 314, 312, and then expect a pullback. Eventually, I'm looking for 324, 322, and 350, 378. Support is now today low and Friday low. Wootsy continues the move. Consumer electronics, big volume, breakout, extending, reach the first target. 14, next target, 17, 20, 20, 2060. And finally, Zynga. Zynga is a pain in the neck, but it's working, believe it or not. Today, popped. Came as high as, let's see, was 11.30, and then a pullback. I took half position, half of my position off, and I maintained the other half position, just because the downward volume today was not huge. It was present, and there was a sell signal, a bearish engulfing on downward volume increase, but not huge. So my stop is 10. And I'm looking for this famous acquisition that somebody is about to purchase this company. Let's see if that's true. It's a rumor. So buy the rumor, sell the news. Let's see when that happens. If it happens, my stop is 10. Secondary support is 970. Target 12.30, 14, 15, 60. And that's it for today. Yep. Did I do VXRT? No, I have two more. VXRT was a day trade that worked really well. Breakout and Evan brought it up. Big volume came in again with the vaccine topic. 9, 20, and 10, 39. Into the close, there was a place to exit, but maintains a bullish look. 12. 13, 15, 17, and then channel top 20, 50. The support is half of this candle, 850, and then today low. And then DVAX also. Oh, no, this recovery. Yeah, okay, so that's it. All right, folks, that's it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.